Okay, Robin, Rory here with a fresh video for today, October 10th, to review the stuff we talked about. And I've gone over everything that I had a lot of notes, and I think that what we're about to do is going to cover it all. So, what you see here is I modified this cabinet in the mudroom to have a door section, a small drawer, and then this will be the lift-up section. The maximum we can do here is a 23-inch door. So that opening will be a little bit smaller than that. These are a framed full overlay cabinet to match your existing cabinets. I could do it in frameless and it would be a little bit tighter and give you a little bit more access, but wouldn't be a full perfect match. Most people wouldn't notice the difference, but if you're trying me to if you want me to match, I give you an exact match, and that's what I've planned for. That's what it looks like here. I just put a support here, okay, and got rid of the panel that would have been here and put some doors on this cabinet and stop it short of the trim because we got the door on there. It takes us to about 11 inches and that'll look great. And let's go do 3D, couple things to look at. I changed your good news about the radius cabinet on the end. I made that 2 inches bigger. So that is now 38 inches deep. That's this guy. 38 inches across and a 19-inch radius. Okay, and then I match that here. That's also the same 19-inch radius. Doesn't change the price. And the reason we did that is because we needed to move this Wayne's panel. We need to pull this forward because of the deeper dishwasher you had. And when I did that, I only had 11 inches of knee space if you were seated at this chair. So we changed that, and now there's 13 and a half here, and that's a great depth. This ceiling line accurate in terms of where it is in your home. I'm not sure where Bruce is going to stop it at what point. I don't think he has to carry it this direction. Let's see what else. Oh, I didn't finish the refrigerator. I gotta fix that. Take that out of there. I thought I had done that. Huh. Must have saved it in a different version. All right. Oh yeah, and then I changed this. That doesn't show as undermounted, but I put in a bigger sink there, and I changed that to 21, which would represent that sink that you really liked. And I took it out of here, and guess what? It only changed this cabinet by 2 inches, I think. And then that's gonna look great there. So we'll put a panel on the back side, panel this side, and countertop dies into that piece of wall right there. On this side, and this is where I'm not, as we discussed, not showing it exactly right. I think what I want to do is make this like a 4.5 inch section between, a solid flat where I'm showing a false drawer. And that 4.5 inches will give you a nice buffer where the countertop hits here. And on the other side, all right, it'll bring the door close, not as close as it, not terribly close, and give you a little extra, give you like a inch and a half extra room there. That'll look great, and it'll make this work on this side. All right, guess that's it. Oh, and there's a little cabinet there. I can't get this wall to disappear, but so I don't know. It may not even be placed correctly in the room, but there's a cabinet, false drawer, two doors, a vessel sink, a top. We just gotta work through the dimensions. One thing you want to be careful about with a vessel sink is, even though you and Mike are tall people, many people find that they put them too high and it's uncomfortable on their arms or their elbows, the forearm would. So just give that a little thought, and then what we do, you tell me where you want this, which I will know if you, or you tell me where you want this, because I don't know which sink you're using, and then how much room you want down here, and I'll handle the rest. Okay, thanks.